Today my lecture that is based on introduction to linked list. What do we mean by linked list? First of all, we need to clear this thing because the student point of view, this linked list topic is very hard to understand. I don't know what is the reason behind it, but today my perspective, I think so, that linked list is the most important and interesting topic of data structure. So what do you mean by data structure, and how data structure can be divided into linear and non-linear linked list, or you can say linear and non-linear data type? First thing that, what do you mean by data structure? Actually, this is a very huge thing. When we are going to build any kind of software, that software should be able to input some query from the user, process that query, and give the output according to programmer perspective, or you can say customer point perspective. So, a data structure is, there is also a proverb that says, bad programmer think about, or you can say bad programmer bother about, you can say coding, and good programmer bother about data structure. So what is data structure now? The important of data structure, what do you mean? Data structure is just give the logical and logical relationship between the different data items. Here, data structure is logical relationship between the different data items. So logical relationship, that is, suppose in terms of my memory, in my memory, suppose I am taking the example of array of int a of 5. So a of 5 array I am going to declare. So this is a of 5 means to say 1 2 3 4 and 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, because total number of item in this array that will be equal to 5, that is the you can say number of item in my array, and this is my memory. I am just taking the some part of my memory and at index of 0, this is subscripted, that is 0, A is the name of that array, and suppose I am going to store this A of 0, that will be 5, let it be. So here is 5, here is 15. Here is 20, here is 25, and let it be here is 28. No issue so far. So this is a linear representation, or you can say linear data types, array. So now the data structure can be divided into two parts on the basis of their logical relationship between them. That is, what are they? First is, array data structure can be divided into linear data items, linear data structure, and second is non-linear data structure, right? So linear and non-linear data structure. Recently I have showed you what do we mean by linear data structure. Similarly, the first and interesting example of linear data structure is my array, right? And second, that is, you can say a stack is also an example of linear data structure, because there is no such kind of relationship between different data items. Clear? And third is linear data structure, that is array, stack, queue, right? And fourth and most interesting data structure in the linear form, that is my linked list, where my lecture is depend on. And for the non-linear data structure, we can say the first and most important that is graph. And second example of non-linear data structure is tree. So how we can differentiate between linear and non-linear data structure, between the, you can say there are logical relationship between them, that here is suppose in linearly I have a memory and memory has the different blocks and there is just storing the data in them, right? But in non-linear data structure we can take the example of tree. Suppose in case of tree, suppose this is my root, right? And here is children of this root A, B, C, and suppose this is my root, here is A, here is B, here is C, and D and E. This is my D and E. So this is example of non-linear data structure. Why? Because A, B, C are connected with one node, that is the root of my tree. So this is, you can say root is also parent, and this is children, right? And suppose what is the relationship between B, A and B? That is a sibling to each other, right? So this is A and B are sibling to each other, or these are connected with the same parent node. So this is the non-linear data structure, right? So this is just a brief introduction where you can say to understand the behavior of linked list, I have to discuss with, or you can say have to cover what is the background behind the background of this lecture. So now linked list, or you can say simple list, this is the linked list is collection of node, and here is node a new term. What is node? Node is basically you can say different kind of data items which has basically in list node is a node containing two parts. First is the data part and second is the pointer to next node, you can say pointer to next node, right? So in data part, let it be, suppose I am taking the example of this is a simple type of linked list, types of linked list, type of linked list. First is the simple linked list, and second is the this is singly linked list. Singly linked list, and second is doubly linked list, and third is the circular linked list, right? So circular linked list, in singly linked list, now I'm going to cover singly linked list only, because it will take hardly two or three lectures to cover this, you can say what is the different type of linked list. Basically I can also divide the singular linked list in further two parts. So that is not my motto. My motto is just to give the introduction about linked list. So what I covered so far, what is list? That is a collection of nodes, right? And where each node is containing two parts. First is a data item and second is a pointer to the next node. Now some other lecture you may also heard about pointer. And what is pointer? Pointer is just containing the memory location of the next data item, right? And in terms of this point to the next node, what is the behavior of that node? That is the different kind of data items. in respective of integer data items as well as the float data items, right? Then different types of linked list, singly linked list. In singly linked list, my node is just containing two parts as the example before. First is the data part and second is the pointer. You can say pointer to the next node. In doubly linked list, I have, suppose, again back to singly linked list, this is my list and here is this pointer containing the address of this node, and suppose this node containing the item of 10 and 20, here is the null, because this pointer does not contain the address of next node and there is no such next, you can say there is no next node, and here is my root, let it be. In singly linked list, this is done so far. In doubly linked list, I have two nodes, suppose two node, and each node containing three different part. Similarly, here is also part number 1, 2 and 3, part number 1, 2 and 3, right? So on the basis of pointer, this pointer node, I can divide my doubly linked class linked list also. So this pointer contain the address of next node, and this pointer containing the next node containing the address of previous node. So similarly, suppose I'm taking the example of this part of my node. So this part containing the address of this node, similarly this part containing the address of my previous node, and here is no such previous node is there, so this is containing the null value. Similarly, if I'm talking about this part of my node, this is also, this should be containing the address of next node, but there is no next node, so this is similarly null value, right? In circular linked list, just suppose here is my two different node. Now this is this containing the address of this node, this containing the address of this node, in the circular form you can say. So this node containing the address of this node, so this is kind of circular shape. So in this there is no such null part of any node, right? So this different kind of linked list. And now I will start singly linked list. Singly linked list. Now start. For singly linked list, as I said earlier, my node is just containing two parts, right? And this node is also you can say attached to any node, clear? Suppose this node is the starting point of my linked list. So starting point of my linked list can be point with another kind of pointer, and name of that pointer is somewhere start, or you can say here is my root pointer. Root pointer, this root contain the address of first node, right? So let it be the memory location of my first node is 1000, clear? So root contain the address of first node, right? So root is a pointer, name of that pointer is root, and it contain the address of this node. This node is the 1000, right? Then this node has the two parts. First is the data part. This is my data part and this is my pointer part. Data part Suppose here is 10 and now this part contains a pointer to my next node. And what is the memory location of this node? Let it be 2000. Right. So this pointer contains the memory address, or you can say address value of this node, and here is 2000. By this way we can connect two nodes to each other, right? Then in here, in this node, the data items contain the value of 20, let it be. And suppose I am going to expand my list, for 2, 3 and let it be 4, right? So now this pointer contains the address of this node. So let it be memory address of this node is 3000. Then here should be the value of 3000, because it is the memory address of this node. Here is 3000. Right. Now suppose I am on the node number 3. The data items is 30 and this pointer contains the address of this node. And here is the memory location is 4000, let it be. Then here is the 4000, right? And here is, now I am here my last node. Suppose the data item of this node is 50 and this pointer does not contain the address of any other node, so in that case this is containing the null value. This is a simple representation of linked list. If any student can understand this kind of behavior of singly linked list, then I think so in future he can do any kind of problem based on linked list. There is some two or three algorithm with the, you can say, their coding. But if we can understand the behavior of linked list in this way, then I think any student can perform any kind of program, any kind of he can run any kind of program, algorithm, graph, tree, because there are also the base of non-linear data structure is the linear data structure. In case of graph and tree, linked list is the, you can say, base of that kind of data structure. Now I'm going to repeat this word. Root contain the address of my first node. This is 1000. So address of first node is 1000. Then first node is divided into two parts. First is the data part and second is the pointer part. Data part may be anything. Pointer should be the address of next node, right? And similarly, node number second contains the data item of this node, and this contains the address of my next node, that is 3000. Then 3000 data item may be anything, and this is the 4000. 4000 is the address of next node, right? So now I'm going to declare this kind of linked list in my memory. Suppose this is a simple program, right? Program, first is I'm going to declare the known, you can say, heterogeneous data type. So this is for declaring, there are two kind of data items. First is the homogeneous and second is the heterogeneous. So homogeneous, when all data items are the same kind of behavior to each other. Suppose in case of array, if I am declaring the array, suppose int a of 5. So every item in my array is the integer type, right? So this is the homogeneous data type, right? Or in case of when I going to work on different data items, then I have to take the heterogeneous data items, right? And heterogeneous data items, suppose this is my integer and this is my pointer. So this is the heterogeneous data structure. So in heterogeneous data structure, I will take help from structure that declare in my C. Structure and name of that structure is node. This is node, and this node containing two parts. First is the integer part, integer of x, let it be, right? Or you can say integer of note x, this is integer of data. And second is this pointer contain the address of same node, because this part is contain the address of next node, and what is the behavior of that node? That is the struct node, right? This is important thing. So here is struct node kind of pointer. Struct node kind of pointer with the name of suppose link. This is struct node kind of pointer with the name of link. And here is my closing of structure. What does it mean? It means integer data part is in the form of integer, and struct node is a self-referential pointer, a special kind of pointer that is self-referential pointer. Self-referential pointer. Self-referential pointer, what does it mean? A new term to every student, I think so. Self-referential pointer is that kind of pointer which contain the address of self kind of data structure. And here is data structure in terms of node. Right. So this is self-referential pointer which point to the same kind of node. In another word, suppose I'm taking this example just to increase the understandability of my students. Suppose integer pointer PTR. What does it mean? PTR is a pointer which contain the memory address of an integer, let it be A, and value of that integer is 15. So address of A is equal to, suppose this is 10,000, so 10,000 should be here, right? So PTR is a pointer which contain address of another pointer, right? Similarly, struct node link, what does it mean? Link is a pointer which point same kind of data structure. And here is the data structure was the integer, here is integer, so that's why here that there was integer. And here is struct node type of pointer. So this is my struct node type of pointer, right? Or you can say, you can also compare this term with the this term. So here is struct node star link. Similarly, here is my link which contain struct node kind of pointer. Here is struct node. Right, suppose base address of this node is 1000, here should be 1000, no, right? And data, here is data part, or maybe that kind of, we will cover it later, right? So here is the link, is a pointer which point struct node kind of data structure. Here is integer kind of pointer which point integer type of data structure, that item, right? Now, a simple program of linked list, right? Suppose in linked list, I have my root. Suppose this is my root, and here is my first node, here is my second node, here is my third node, here is my fourth node, right? Here is my node, right? So root is a pointer which point to the node kind of data structure. Or you can say here is root should be, suppose root is defined on global basis, So global variable is my root. So struck node star root, right? And second is struct node star struct node I'm just taking the suppose for a program structure has been defined structure node and node containing the integer of data part and here is the struct node star link right so this is I am going to define my structure in global basis whenever I will just call this kind of data structure so here is now I am going to define my root that is the pointer of type struct node right and in globally suppose this is null let it be now int main this is my main program and here is int main I have to define or you can say in main I have to call this structure right so in main struct node star temp right now this root in somewhere in my computer memory somewhere in my computer memory you can say this is my structure of C process when any C program you can say when any C program start from the start then after saving that program that save into my hard disk right so that hard disk is kind of C program when I'm going to execute that those code then program take some part on my main memory and turn into process right so in main memory this is structure of C process right now this is my struct node no issue because in run time in compile time you can say sorry in compile time structure does not allocate any kind of memory right then this is my global variable this is my global variable right this is my global variable so in case of this C process I have process ID when program change into process right then it has its own ID then code segment contain the global variables right global variable static variable are the part of global variable and static variable are part of my data segment right data segment contain the base you can say global variable in terms of in this global variable the name of my variable is root right and it start with the null value now code segment is you can say it just contain the base address of any function all my function in my main or you can say in my program it just contain the base address of that program that function right suppose in main I have defined another 2, 3, 4 function just code segment contain the base address of all functions right now it is my heap is just for when I need dynamic memory allocation heap is just used for dynamic memory allocation by using malloc calloc and reloc right or then this is my heap for dynamic memory allocation and struct this is stack is work on last in first out right or you can say first in last out right So this is my main program. That is my first function, you can say entry point of my program, right? So stack contain the main with some local variable to this function, right? Anyway, just and heap is going to increase upwards and stack is going to increase downwards. Remember this. Yeah. Now back to topic. That is struct node start temp. This is local variable to my main function. Local variable to my main function. Then this is my temp. Name of my function is temp. This is my function. Temp is variable is equal to null. Let it be, because by default you can say it is a basic kind of programming where every pointer should be start with a null value initially, right? So this is my null. Then this temp should have the address of my first node. So what is the syntax of declaring that node? That is temp is equal to, temp is a pointer which contain the address of node, right? So temp is equal to how many number of byte I need to define my node in my memory. That is undefined. You can see that is machine dependent, right? So so size of is a operator which return the number of block to need from heap, right? So size of how many byte required in dynamic memory, right? And suppose this is my struct node. In dynamic memory allocation, I can just initialize my memory with the, you can allocate my memory with the malloc function or calloc function. So here is malloc size of struct node, right? And return type of malloc function is always void, right? So I have to cast. So to casting the malloc function, I have casting struct node star. What does it mean? It means temp defined in my stack that has the base address in my heap. And suppose here is a number of block that heap and base address that heap is 1000, right? So temp has updated its value by this line and it has the 1000, right? So by this way I have allocate base address, you can say base address of, let it be in case of struct node, memory needed was let it be 8 byte. I don't think so, it is just machine dependent. I'm taking the example. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 are as these block are allocated, right? Now just now I have my node, right? Node in heap and each node containing two parts. So first is temp of, now I have temp of data and temp of link, right? I am taking the example declaring the first node or this node, right? And there is, let it be, there is no another node right now I am taking. So here is temp is my pointer, which point a data value from heap, right? So whenever I need to point from stack to dynamic memory allocation, I just need my arrow head, right? So temp is a pointer in stack or in local to any function in my stack, which point somewhere in my heap, right? So at this point of time, I have to take the example of arrow head, right? This is significance. And suppose here is the data in terms of integer. Suppose here is data in terms of integer, and data may be suppose 115, right? And now next part of my node is link. So by default, temp is a pointer which has accessibility to my second part, and this is also a pointer initially. So name of that pointer is my link is equal to what? Null. Right. So here temp allocated and initialized, data is 115 and here is null, right? Now my duty is I have defined root in global variable, just replace the update the value of root with the value of temp, whatever temp is containing the value. So root is equal to temp, right? So just update the value of root with the temp. So here is the value is 1000 and 1000 is here. So temp is also containing the address of a node in my memory, and the root is also containing the address of my memory. This is 1000 is